Hello, welcome to invalid.com. Today's video is all about manipulating keyboard using C or C++. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to use register hotkey. Register hotkey is used to look for a match against the hotkey that I'm going to use in this program. And number two, set event to send a signal to the waiting state object. And number three, wait for single object. It's a object state which is non-signaled. And number four, send input to insert the event in the input structures into the keyboard. So let's get started. Open your Visual C++. Create a project. Keyboard, and then create one file here named cpp. Okay, so we need the following header. We need windows.h. process.h, because we're going to use thread here. Then include stdio.h, and then main okay, and then we'll create init function here. Okay, okay, next would be handle empty. And then here we're going to use the thread using begin thread. Pass this null, so, and then the function, and then here this would be the hotkey to be registered. Okay. If this example equals to 0, then F. Could not begin thread. Then when you clear this function, add sign std phone. And then void args to get any parameter. So at this point, some okay, keys, and then and then we'll get the length of the keys that we enter into the thread. So to do that, key len and then strlen. Let's compile first. Okay. Now here we're going to register every character that I mentioned on the parameter. So int I 0, I is less than kln, and then if. So here I'm going to use register hotkey. So first parameter will be null. What's the use of this register hotkey? So first parameter ID would be the identifier of the key, and then modifier shift. Okay, first the identifier of the character, and then shift, and then the character. Okay. And then if the function success, the return value is non-zero. Okay. I can see here print f hotkey. So since I'm going to use this one, plus character. So yes, that. Okay. Now register hotkey. We're going to use this function. Okay, and then now we need to find which key we type on the keyboard. So to do that, you have to check like keys, and then you have to use this message. What is that? W param. This W param would be the doesn't say anything here. But this W param is the identifier of the key. Okay, and then if we press S, we'll go here. So here we mention only, I mention only SMB. So we can add another one here else. And this is for B. Okay, let's compile. Okay. So add on the register hotkey. And okay, so what's next? So set event. So set event. So what we can do here. So if I press S, we're going to send signal to the thread. Okay, so here to set event, and then we're going to declare a global variable handle, so global key press event. Okay. So we need to create event. So let's go back in this code. And init. So we're going to create non-signal event. Okay, so here we're going to use the variable I declared, and then say create event. Pass null, false, null. Okay. Let's compile. Okay. Now, the next, wait for single object. So for this one, we need to create another thread. Let's copy this code. And this should be pivot. And then this should be thread. And then we're going to pass this okay. Now we're going to create thread. I'm assigned as digital. And then here we need to get the key event handle. So we need to get it from here. So we can just key the event. Handle. Okay, and then the word. So this thread is actually they call it non-signal state. Okay. here we enter as a weight object. Okay, so while true, okay, here we are going to use wait for single object. And the key event, then say infinite. Okay. If, okay. Equals or is that with object. Then do something. Let's compile. Okay. Next. Send input. Now let's check and let's search actually. Send input. Okay. Okay, we can use this one. Actually, this program is done by Ted Brook. Okay, let's copy this code and then we'll create another function here. So send key input. Okay, and then need to pass value here. Here we're going to pass virtual key code. Okay. Okay, we don't need this one. This 41. It's equivalent to letter A. That's what it says here. So 41, which is actually equivalent to the integer value is 65. Okay. So here, A is equivalent to, which is it, that's this hex value, and then the integer value is 65. Okay, but if you are using Unicode, A is equivalent to 97. So we need to pass like 97 minus 64 is always equivalent to 32. Okay, so now here from A to Z, if virtual key BK is equals what is the space bar here? This one. Virtual key code for spacebar. 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 Okay, next, and if A is equals to else, here minus 32 virtual key code for virtual key code between A to Z. Okay, now we're gonna need this one. Okay. Let's compile. Okay, now we're going to use this one inside here. Okay. So let's say, for example, A. and then we'll put slip here delay for at least half a second. Okay, let's review the code. Event thread. Let's run. There should be some kind of let's create another variable here. So global is loop true. Okay, let's open Notepad. If I press Shift S, then there should be signal to the waiting object, and then it will enter A. Okay. Now let's create another variable here. This variable will hold keys. Let's say 32. Okay, and then we'll declare here str copy. Brown box jump over the DC door. Okay, so from this event, there should be loop here. So for I say if keys length str copy str length, and then I system. And then compile. Let's create a string. Now here, we are expecting that when we press Shift S, it will write the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Okay, let's run. Too small. Okay, fine. So we'll make it 100. This one. Shift S. The quick. Too slow. Okay. Let's finish this sentence first. We'll make it fast. Where is that? So we'll make it 100. Okay. Now we'll add more exciting part here. Okay. So what I want, if I press Shift S, it will keep typing, okay? It will stop only if I press Shift S again. Okay, let's do that. Now to do that, we need to create another variable called isPress. Okay, so isPress by default should be false, and then here. Okay, press. Here. Okay. Now let's run. Now Shift S. Now it will stop only when I press Shift S again. Shift S. That's it. Shift S. Shift S. Shift S. Shift S. Now we need to add more. After typing, we need to send carriage return. What is the carriage enter key here? Let's send this one. Okay. Okay, now start. Keep S. Now shift S again. Now, how to exit from the program? Okay, so since I create another else condition here, if I press B, okay, so if I press B, what can we do? We have loop here, so we will make it false. And then here, since it is looping here, it will stop the program. Shift S. Shift S. Shift S. And then Shift B. Now the program stop. Okay. So, okay, thank you for watching this video, and if you have any question, just please below this video. And if you like the video, just press like and don't forget to share it. And bye for now.